are you?
Good.
Most of the traveling that we do to and from our calling spots is done very quietly. We can get away with a little bit of ambient motor noise, but talking carries across the water for a mile or two to a moose. So basically no talking when we're in the boat, we're just trying to be as quiet as possible. one of my favorite calling areas. We had called in this area the night before, the evening before, and returned in the morning hoping a bull might have come during the night. After calling for about an hour, this bull swam the river and showed up pretty much in front of us with no time to get any decent video coverage at all. I kept calling to try to hold the bull during the shot.
Well, although we didn't get it on camera because it...
I can still see him moving, though.
Yeah, it happened so quick. Brad just shot himself a really nice bull. And the bull went down right over by the river. So quick, we didn't get it on film. I didn't get my earplugs in.
You don't have to be on film, that's in my heart forever.
And yeah, what a nice bull. We started calling this morning at 7:30, and this bull came in fairly quietly until he got in right close.
He either had to swim the river or come down the beach.
Yeah. So what do you think about that, Brad?
Best feeling in the world. Oh, man.
Congratulations.
I think I'm pretty sure I hit him at least 3 or 4 times.
Yeah. Yeah, Brian just got himself a beautiful bull. It's 8:30. What day is it?
Thursday.
What's the date?
The 20, maybe the 20. I got, if I can quit shaking, I'll tell you. 21st.
September 21st, 8:30 in the morning.
Oh, man.
Dead quiet this morning. We started calling at 7:30. And this bull showed up at 8:30. Right in front of us. Quietly to begin with. Brad heard a couple of small grunts.
Yeah, I could hear him.
Yeah. We're not sure whether he walked down the river bank just out of our sight or
swam the river.
Whether he swam over to us. But he just appeared right in front of us. And that was a pretty exciting moment. Had a really quiet first 2 days. Hadn't seen much, hadn't seen anything actually. And obviously this bull came to the call, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and this rut has begun. I think Brad's pretty happy about that.
Couldn't be happier.
Here's the happy guide again. Yeah, it worked out just exactly the way it was supposed to.
Beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Happened a little quicker than I planned. I would have liked to have got it on video, but it was, the bull showed up right beside us. Whoa, nice ball. Congratulations, Brad.
Look at that size.
Go ahead and touch him. Put your hands on him. He's yours.
Wow, what a freaking...
What do you got to say, Brad?
Unbelievable. Oh, my God. Oh.
Brad made some nice shots, eh?
I was shooting through a lot of brush.
Yeah. Well, he was out there a bit too.
Wow.
Yeah, you might as well take all the bullets out of your gun. What a nice bull. What a nice bull.
He swam across.
Yeah, yeah.
We didn't even see him swim.
Wow, there's lots of brush in front of us. What a nice bull. Well, don't be having a heart attack on me.
I gotta get a picture of him. I want you in a picture too.
Oh, we'll get lots of pictures after. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. It's the third full day of hunting. And right about halfway through, and we really had not much action other than some fresh tracks and stuff until this morning. And it's an absolutely picture-perfect morning, quiet. This bull came, apparently swam the river, and came up right in front of us.
Well, Brad and I were in camp, and Scott and Bob were miles away hunting. this bull showed up south of camp and spent some time there. He swam the river and then eventually showed up on an island across from camp. And by his attention, he knew something was going on our side. Eventually, he swam the river to our side and disappeared.
Thank you.
Take care, you guys.